I didn't know growing up that I could be an actor. You know, it wasn't even a possibility. Which is ironic, seeing how I was basically raised on television. You know, my parents were immigrants and they were both working, and we were latchkey kids. Back in those days, you could just leave your kids at home alone. You have to have babysitters. And I turned on the TV. That's how I learned how to speak English.
Love you so much, Appa.
Yeah, love you too, TV.
I graduated from high school, and I never took drama in high school, no theater, this or that. I'd seen a play. And what happened was I saw this thing for the UC drama program at U of T. I really fell in love with the craft of acting. Oh my God, you might be able to act professionally for like real money.
Now you're talking.
I knew I wasn't ever gonna be a lead on a television series because of the way I looked. I was too old looking to play the young guys. I was too young looking to play the older guys. And I was kind of stuck in this nether world. I decided I might not be a lead actor, but what I could be is an excellent character actor.
This is a successful phase. Why are you making that phase?
I just sort of reset what my expectations were. And then this lovely little show called Kim's Convenience came. Yeah, Ins called me up and I read these two scenes and I fell in love with the character, and it was just, that was my dad. That was my Samshin, my Adishis, all these Korean men that I knew growing up. You know, when you see stories that don't reflect your own family, you start to think that your own stories aren't as important. To finally hear those voices being spoken aloud really brought a tear to my eye. You know, it wasn't just the Korean community that embraced it. It was everyone with family. It just sort of exploded from there. And then all this sort of comes. It's like, how can you not feel like you're living in a dream?